Karachi is still Pakistan's major maritime link to the outside world and handles over 60% of the country's imports and almost all of its exports. As we travel by boat under tight security through the waters that look more gray than blue because of the toxic mix of sewage and industrial effluent produced by a city now bursting at the seams, there are fewer ships in port and most of the berths reserved for bulk carriers are empty. As we go past the oil terminal, we can see the port's newer South Wharf, built by a Chinese company on land reclaimed from the sea. Also known as China Port, this section handles thousands of containers.
Karachi port is not damaged, it is going to stay. And especially with the inception of this container terminal, we are capable of handling the largest container ships. So the Karachi port will survive.
Although the port can handle 150 million tons of cargo a year, it now handles just 60 million tons. And that is due to a faltering economy and a drop in exports. Many blame the decline on rampant corruption and say that while Pakistan has the capacity, its systems need a total revamp. The government says a mix of public money and private investment will pay for the improvements.
Pakistan, once upon a time, used to be a big maritime nation. There were companies here which had independent individual companies that had 150, 200 ships. Big shipping magnates were Pakistanis. The downfall of any industry is corruption. We are coming in aggressively with policies which will allow businessmen, not allow, but in fact encourage businessmen to now buy ships and register them in Pakistan.
We meet the chairman of the Karachi Port Trust Authority, who tells us plans are already getting final touches. That include cleaning up the port with a water treatment plant. And there are other plans too.
Ironically, we are paying over $4.5 billion every year on account of freight. And this all gets paid in foreign exchange. Now, we can save on this if we have our own flag carriers. And there are plans for more ships to be inducted in the PNSC fleet.
He tells us there's a huge potential for trade and steps are underway to improve connectivity by building pipelines to carry gas and oil out of the port and build a bridge to connect Bin Qasim port with Karachi port and the rest of the country. Karachi port not only caters to Pakistan's growing needs, but also provides a transit and transshipment facility for landlocked countries of the Central Asian states and Afghanistan. The future of this port, built in the mid-19th century, now depends on the performance of Imran Khan's fledgling government and its stated desire to boost Pakistan's industry, which was once the pride of this country. Kamal, Hyder, Al Jazeera, Karachi Port.